Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. So if you were watching my video a couple weeks ago, you knew that I was really excited to talk about this box. I've mentioned Iuna before on my channel multiple times, so yeah, I have a lot to say. So let's first start with Iuna the brand. It was founded by two women, Begonia San Juan, who I believe has the esthetician, the spa background, and then there's Dr. Isabel Ramos, which is the scientist and formulator behind the brand. They kind of came together to form a brand that focused on well aging, that focused on less is more, that focused on topical skin fasting, and a simplified routine, all to kind of give you your best skin as we age. Which is something I think we're all interested in. So now let me tell you a little bit about my bias towards this brand and where this kind of all started for me. Obviously, they came out on the market with a product that is a really beautifully packaged, but also $198. And this is kind of when these green beauty prices were kind of skyrocketing for oil blends and really simple products and packaged in very beautiful packaging. And I think a lot of people were feeling disconnected and a lot of people were feeling alienated and also maybe a little bit duped at times by green beauty. And so I gave them the side eye, if you will. I looked over their ingredients list, I looked at the price tag, I looked at the packaging, and I was just like, not having it, not buying it. I even put them in an anti-haul. And I mention all of this because if they could convert me to a believer of their products, and convert me, somebody who likes to look up every single ingredient in a product, to understanding their vision and really what truly sets them apart in green beauty. So I think I'm kind of the perfect person to tell you whether or not you may like their products. I like to mention that bias because beautiful packaging doesn't really sway me. Beautiful formulas do. So we'll jump into that a little bit more when we talk about one of the products. So first things first, these came to me by way of a Beauty Heroes box. They do send it to me for review. If you were to purchase the Beauty Heroes box, it is $42. You do have to sign up for 3 months at a time, and shipping is included. If you were to purchase these products outside of the box, it would be $198 for 50 mls. This is half the full size. The full size is 200 mls and it goes for $118, making this around, I would guess, $60, $55. So that's kind of the lowdown on pricing. So that is what really gets people's attention right off the bat, is these products are expensive. Let's jump into the formulas to talk about maybe why. So as we go through the ingredients list, you're gonna see a lot of synthetic ingredients. What you have to know about Iuna is they are at the forefront of cosmetic chemistry. They're formulated by a proper cosmetic chemist. They have beautiful formulas. Yes, there's a lot of synthetic ingredients. Does that make it unsafe? No. No, it doesn't. It means that it feels lovely on the skin. It means that it does things for your skin. It means that it's properly preserved, and it stays together. It stays emulsified in its formula. And so I really like to point that out, that just because it's a long list of synthetic ingredients does not mean it's not safe. In fact, one of the things that I love the most about the Iuna brand, as I've kind of been studying them, as I've been watching them in the community, is that, you know, they really are helping to bridge the gap between conventional beauty and green beauty. We're seeing with more and more products and brands like Iuna that are following all the natural standards that we have and still creating fully functional, high-performance skincare. It's just demonstrating to conventional beauty, like, hey, this is what the consumer is asking for. We're able to give it to them, and more people are wanting to follow suit. You see that with parabens, you see that with formaldehyde releaser preservatives. So yeah, Iuna is an exciting brand to me. So let's talk about, I wanted to mention something first. When I go to look up ingredients, I really like to use PubMed, the open chemistry one. I'll show you a little screenshot here of what you can do. So here's an ingredient that is both in the cream, the face cream, and the body cream.
So you see up here, it says PubChem, Open Chemistry Database. You can search any synthetic ingredient. So then what I like is if you come over here on some of them, it'll have structure, vendors, literature, patents, bioactivities. On some of the other ingredients, it'll have studies. Like, it's just a really great resource for getting non-biased info. So you can come down here, you can check out uses and manufacturing, methods of manufacturing, safety hazards, if anybody's, you know, and remember, you have to be able to put this kind of stuff in context that, you know, it's a cosmetic ingredient. You can see a lot of different information here that's maybe not going to pertain to cosmetics, but if you're a nerd like me, and then you might really like this site.
I also like to use Lotion Crafter as a place to look up ingredients because they also have the MSDSs on the ingredients. They also have some literature. You can also see maybe what the ingredients would be in a product's formulas for percentage wise. Like, oh, I see this ingredient. What would the common percentage usage be for that? I also like to use Truth in Aging, and I also like to use Polish Choice. I prefer to stay off the EWG. I don't find that one as helpful. I prefer to be looking more for unbiased, sort of just here's the factual information. So I showed you a swatch already of the cream. Interestingly enough, the cream, this is the lighter version of the cream. They have two, cream one and cream two. The cream two is supposed to be for more drier skin, but actually I tried that one in the November Beauty Heroes box last year, but actually I ended up liking this cream one a lot more. I was kind of shocked, specifically because the texture is so lightweight. I was immediately happy that I could automatically tell just from looking at the formula that it doesn't have very much shea butter, even though in the ingredients list it does list shea butter. The texture is much more lightweight compared to the cream too. When I get into talking about both of these products, they're both creams. So you're gonna see some crossover ingredients. What makes a cream a cream? Well, you have to take water and mix it with oil, and then you need something to mix it up called an emulsifier. Sometimes you need something to even help the emulsifier. You may have a co-emulsifier. Sometimes you may have a stabilizer in there. Sometimes you may have other things that support it being a cream. Then you have your active ingredients, and then you have your other things like preservatives that are thrown in there. And then, because Iuna, like I said, is kind of on the forefront of more conventional cosmetic chemistry, you have the skin conditioners and the things that play into the way that we touch and feel a product and the way it dries down, and all of those things have been paid attention into these products. But what I wanted to say is some of the nuts and bolts crossover. The basis of this is lemon fruit extract water, propandiol, which can be an absorption enhancer. It has another emollient in here, called Citiol. I actually listed a link below if you wanted to check it out. It has water, more emollients, glycerin, more emulsifiers. It has sweet almond oil, shea butter. It has preservatives. And like I said, you can go down to the description box and see everything broken down. So one of the things that is kind of like the highlight of this product, that is kind of the star ingredients, why it's so expensive, are these phytopeptides, these botanical cell factors that are grown in these special medias. So they have turmeric, they have gotukula, they have carrot root, they have cotton, what is it called? Arabian cotton and pomegranate. So you know how I love peptides. So all of these things are supposed to be contributing to feeding the skin. So we have these super highly specialized fancy ingredients that you can't buy on Lotion Crafter, formulated in this beautiful textured cream with an absorption enhancer. So the idea is this is really all you need as a skin treatment. Now let's just talk about the nuts and bolts of it, okay? So it reminds me in texture and the way that it dries down to the Jane Shriver OO cream. If you're not familiar with that product, what it does is it's meant to be worn over oil and then it dries down matte. So this product is exactly like that, except I believe that there's an ingredient in here from my research called this cetiol that actually makes the product do that on purpose. So that drying down matte that, you know, obviously it's a lighter cream meant for maybe more oily skin types, maybe meant for more warmer climates. I know particularly this summer, I have really enjoyed this product since it arrived in early July because it's been so hot here. So this product dries down nicely and it doesn't really move. So that's been really nice. I've really enjoyed that. So ways that I think you could use it, right? You could definitely use it, in my opinion, as a treatment serum because it goes on so light. And then if you have drier skin and you want it in your dry areas, like sometimes what I would do is apply it to my cheeks and then just right here on my forehead where I get really dry overnight sometimes, I'll apply just a little bit of extra cream on top. So the first time I used it, I was like, oh, no way, because it immediately dried down matte. I was like, this isn't gonna work for me. This just isn't heavy enough. But of course, I wanted to try it just as they had envisioned it. So I just put it on bare skin and I woke up the next morning and my skin felt lovely. It felt perfectly conditioned. It felt perfectly moisturized. And I was like, you would never have convinced me last night with the way my skin felt, you know, that I would have woke up with this sort of glowy, dewy skin. So that's the nuts and bolts on this. 50 mls, it's full size. Would I purchase this outside of a subscription box? I don't know. That's where the price tag really comes into, are you seeing benefits? Now, to get it in a subscription box to try it out, absolutely, I'm excited and I love it. But really putting it to the test is gonna take 2 months to see whether or not these ingredients really are contributing or if you see results. I think you know what I mean. Okay, so now let's go on to the body lotion. So the focus of this product is that it's probiotic skincare. Now, if you are a dork like me, you probably read around on some of the more cosmetic chemist sites, and you've maybe even heard of this book by Perry Romanowski. And he actually has a part in here about yogurt and probiotics in skincare. One of the things that he mentioned is an article that was published in the Journal of Cosmetic Chemists. I can't read it because I don't have access to that journal. But one of the things that they say is topically applied, there's very limited probiotics that actually do anything. They did mention this one down here as being beneficial in concentrations of 5%. So going into this, like, probiotic skincare. What do you think? What do I think? What do you think? I'm open to that concept, and I'm sure were we to have the Iuna founders here, they would definitely be able to give us a little bit more insight into the formulation and how it benefits the skin. So what I wanted to say is the basis of this is water. It has some emollients. One thing that I do notice in both of their products, which I need to email them about, or maybe somebody knows, is they use corn germ oil in here, and they also use soybean oil, I think, in all of their products. So we would really love to hear sort of a, hey, it's non-GMO soy and corn. I would love to hear them comment that, and maybe they have, and I just don't know. So then there's the corn germ oil. They have the propandiol, which can function, like we mentioned with the cream, as an absorption enhancer. It can function as a preservative. It can function as a humectant. Soybean oil, glycerin, skin conditioner, shea butter, emollient, preservatives. When you kind of look through here, there's multiple ingredients that they're using as preservatives. And I think on the cream, they've actually starred them. But when you look through here, I can pick it out right away which ones are the preservatives. They have some more emulsifiers, they have beeswax, they have calendula. I love my calendula. They also have nani fruit extract, which is a great ingredient for the skin. We all know how I feel about that. The coconut fruit extract, a lot of times that's included with one of the preservatives. So, you know, very straightforward. And the nuts and bolts are similar in the cream aspect and the preservative aspect. the thing that's kind of sets them apart is this probiotics in here. So you see Lactobacillus mentioned two times. I believe one of those is the preservative and the other one is the probiotics. They don't go more into specifics about which Lactobacillus. So anyway, that's a lot of information about that. Let's look at the way it applies. This applies like a typical cream to me. Very lightweight, very breathable, which I love in a body cream. And one of the things I want to mention, one of the reasons I've been loving it, is I get this when I'm not being 100% on my diet, as far as avoiding sugar and wheat. I will get this like intense itching right here. But one of the really nice things I've been using is I've been saving this cream for this part of my arm. Because, like I said, I do get that intense itching. And it's one of those things, like, it's kind of like this neuropathy / food irritation. And I'm like I said, I always know when I'm going to get it based on, like, if I've had a couple bad days of eating. And it's the kind of itching that's not even relieved with scratching. Like, it's not like a mosquito bite. It just sits there and itches. And so I've been using this probiotic cream here, and it's been really helping. Like, I kind of been saving it, and whenever I feel an outbreak coming on, I'll use that. So I've really been enjoying it. It does have their signature Iuna scent, so I know not everyone loved it, but if you do enjoy the scent, it has that signature Iuna scent. So overall, for me, a great deal, a great box. This cream is just beyond dreamy. Like I said, I've been using it as a treatment serum with maybe like a touch of a thicker cream on top overnight. During the day, this works perfectly with the Honua sunscreen because it dries down matte. And then the Honua sunscreen is very lush, so you apply it on top and then you're good to go. And so just another phenomenal month by Beauty Heroes. I was really excited to see this brand featured again. So. Any questions, comments, thoughts, leave them below, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.